I was raised in a Christian home. My mom and dad, they took us to church when we were younger. And we went to a little Free Will Baptist church in 80, it was up in 81. And we went all the time until, and my dad, he was a carpenter. And so he did a lot of work in the church until one time something was said, and like today, sometimes people get their feelings hurt. Well, something was said, he got hurt, and he never went back. But, and I never did find out what it was. I guess I didn't need to. But my mom, she kept going. But, you know, as time went by, we kind of fell away a little bit. And was young kids, and when your dad's not going, it kind of, you know, you stray away. And but anyway, so later on, my neighbors, they invited me to go to church with them. And they had some boys that was my age, so I was running around with them. And so I went with them. And I got saved. That night, that day, it was in a class. And I can remember to this day, my heart was pounding out of my chest. And I still remember going up in front of the church and the people coming up and hugging me and telling me how much they loved me, you know. And but then after that, you know, you kind of get in your teenage years and you kind of you stray away a little bit there, too. And I never did get baptized. They didn't have a baptistry. And so it had to be baptized in the creek. And so I never was. Still, and I knew I needed to, but it was later on, until after me and Kim got married, that we found us a church. And I got baptized. My dad actually come and seen me be baptized. So, you know, that was a big thing. But we started having a family. We had Kendi, and then Natalie and Brandon. And Kendi and Natalie, they're both serving the Lord. They were saved at an early age. And our son, he said he was, but he's not going anywhere. And it's pretty tough. You know he was raised in it, but he's not doing what he needs to do. Anyway, so I got baptized, and we started getting involved in church, and we knew the kids need to be involved. So we started, we made sure we got them there, and they was involved in all the classes, and I think that it was a good thing. But like I said, we didn't always do everything right, but you have to keep trying, doing your best, what you can do. But anyway, I've had a lot of good things in my life, and a lot of trials, and I mean, I know Kenny's gonna laugh at me because I've told this story so many times that when I was in the second grade, I got run over by a car in Alma. My mom and dad had taken us to a show down there, and after the show, my dad was out waiting on me, and he said, when I come out, he said, don't cross the street, you'll get run over. You know, it's kind of like today, you don't, like kids today, you would wonder why they don't pay attention. Well, I didn't do it then either. Well, I ran out in front of him, and this car hit me, and my dad told me it rolled me down the street. And but God had his hand on me, because all I got was scratches and bruises. I mean, I was able to go to school Monday after Saturday. That was Saturday. They took me to the hospital. Nothing was wrong. So, that I got run over by a car in Alma. My mom and dad had taken us to a show down there. And after the show, my dad was out waiting on me. And he said, when I come out, he said, don't cross the street, you'll get run over. You know, it's kind of like today, you don't, like kids today, you would wonder why they don't pay attention. Well, I didn't do it then either. Well, I ran out in front of him, and this car hit me, and my dad told me it rolled me down the street. And but God had his hand on me, because all I got was scratches and bruises. I mean, I was able to go to school Monday after Saturday. That was Saturday. They took me to the hospital, nothing was wrong. So.